On the occasion of today's International Day of Women and Girls in Science, I would like to mention one of the women who is most respected in the scientific community, Marie Curie. The great scientist was a chemist and physicist who carried out groundbreaking studies on radioactivity, a term she invented. Marie was a unique woman with a passion for life and an insatiable desire for knowledge. Every part of our existence may be summed up by her famous phrase, "Nothing in life is to be feared, it is only to be understood. Now is the time to understand more so that we may fear less." She achieved widespread recognition. In a room filled with male scientists, Marie Curie was occasionally the only woman. Marie is arguably the first woman to contribute so much to science. The scientist was the first woman to receive a Nobel Prize, the first and only female recipient of a Nobel Prize twice, and the first recipient of a Nobel Prize in two distinct fields of science. Scientists all across the world held Marie Curie in high regard and respect for her dignity, modesty, and quiet demeanor. According to a quote from Albert Einstein, Marie Curie is of all celebrated beings the only one whom fame has not corrupted. Marie Curie was born Maria Salome Skłodowska in Warsaw on November 7, 1867, which at the time was the capital of the Kingdom of Poland, part of the Russian Empire. She was the youngest and fifth child of teachers Władysław Skłodowski and Bronisława Nie Boguska. While Maria's mother was an ardent Catholic, her father was an atheist. Mania was a nickname given to Maria. The family had lost their possessions and wealth as a result of their patriotic participation in Polish national uprising to re-establish Poland's independence. Early in her life, Maria lost her sister Sofia to typhus, and in May 1878, her mother passed away from tuberculosis. Their deaths led Maria to renounce her Catholic faith and become agnostic. Marie Curie was Polish and naturalized French. Due to her gender, she was unable to enroll in a traditional higher education institution and attended the clandestine Flying University in Warsaw that accepted female students. In 1891, she departed Poland for France and began her studies in Paris, where she completed her advanced degrees and afterwards carried out her scientific research. She survived on her few resources, dressing herself in all she owned to be worn through the chilly winters. She occasionally neglected to eat, since she was so consumed with her studies. In 1894, the French physicist Pierre Curie entered her life. They became closer as a result of their shared love of science and eventually started to fall in love. In 1895, Pierre Curie and Maria Skłodowska were married in Sceaux. Neither desired a religious ceremony. Marie Curie, her husband Pierre Curie, and the physicist Henri Becquerel shared the 1903 Nobel Prize in Physics for their groundbreaking work establishing the theory of radioactivity. Marie and Pierre Curie was the first married couple in history to share a Nobel Prize. Marie proposed the theory that the radiation must originate from the atom itself and not from any interaction of molecules. This idea was a crucial first step in rejecting the idea that atoms are indestructible. They were not aware of the harmful radiation exposure consequences of their continuing uncovered employment with radioactive materials. In a study, the Curies reported that when exposed to radium, sick tumor-forming cells were killed more quickly than healthy ones. A brand new industry centered on radium started to emerge. The Curies did not patent their discoveries and received nothing from their increasingly successful business. Unfortunately, on the 19th of April 1906, Pierre Curie died in a street accident in Paris. He fell under the wheels of a horse-drawn carriage after being struck by it, fractured his skull, and died instantaneously. The loss of her husband grieved Marie. In 1906, the University of Paris Physics Department made the decision to keep the chair established in honor of her late spouse and offer it to Marie. She became the first female professor at the University of Paris. Marie Skłodowska-Curie, who used both surnames, was a French citizen but never lost the sense of her Polish origin. She gave her birth country, Poland, the name of the first chemical element she discovered. Using methods she developed for isolating radioactive isotopes, Marie achieved the isolation of radium in 1910 and earned the 1911 Nobel Prize in Chemistry for her discovery of the elements polonium and radium, from the Latin term for ray. However, Marie had a confusing year in 1911. On the one hand, she received the Nobel Prize in Chemistry, but on the other, she caused a major scandal when her relationship with Paul Langevin, a scientist 5 years her junior and former assistant in Pierre's lab, who had fathered 4 children, became public. Marie regained her composure once more, helped by the encouraging words of extraordinary friends, including Albert Einstein. In a letter to Curie, Albert Einstein expressed his unwavering sympathy and support and urged her not to pay any attention to the divisive journalistic commentary. The letter exemplifies Einstein's unmatched generosity of heart as well as his extraordinary intelligence. He wrote to her, "Highly esteemed Mrs. Curie, I am so enraged by the base manner in which the public is presently daring to concern itself with you that I absolutely must give vent to this feeling. I am impelled to tell you how much I have come to admire your intellect, your drive, and your honesty, and that I consider myself lucky to have made your personal acquaintance in Brussels." She was hospitalized for depression and a kidney illness a month after receiving her Nobel Prize. After a break of around 14 months, she returned to her lab. The first research into using radioactive isotopes to treat neoplasms were carried out globally under her guidance. Curie saved countless soldiers' lives during World War I. She and her 17-year-old daughter, Irene, developed mobile radiography devices called Petites Curies, Little Curies, to offer X-ray services to field hospitals. She established 2 important medical research institutions, the Curie Institute in Paris in 1920 and the Curie Institute in Warsaw in 1932. Curie never got any official recognition from the French government for her humanitarian services to the country's war effort. Marie Curie visited the United States in 1921 and was treated like a superstar when she arrived. She was the only female participant at the 1927 Solvay Conference on Quantum Mechanics. Unfortunately, Marie Curie died of aplastic anemia on July 4, 1934, at the age of 66, in the San Selmo Sanitarium in Passy, Haute-Savoie, France, most likely as a result of radiation exposure from her scientific work and her radiological work at field hospitals during World War I. Along with her husband Pierre, she was buried in the Sceaux Cemetery. 60 years later, in 1995, the remains of both were moved to the Paris Pantheon as a tribute to their accomplishments. Marie became the first woman to be buried in the Paris Pantheon on her own merits. Her papers are too risky to handle due to the radioactive contamination levels. Lead-lined bins are used to store her documents, and anybody who wants to consult them needs to be wearing protective gear. She left 2 daughters, Irene, born 1897, and Eve, born 1904. Like her mother, Irene went into the field of science study. She and her husband, Frédéric Joliot, worked on the atom's nucleus and were jointly awarded the Nobel Prize for their work, which is credited with discovering artificial radiation. Irene also passed away from leukemia, a radiation-related disease, in 1956, aged 58. Marie Curie was respected for her integrity and restrained way of living. She donated a large portion of the earnings from the first Nobel Prize to her family, friends, scientific collaborators, and students. Curie made an exceptional choice by deciding not to patent the radium isolation method so that the scientific community may conduct research without restriction. Marie requested that financial contributions and honors go to the scientific organizations she was associated with, not to her. She and her husband frequently declined honors and medals. Many subsequent developments paid tribute to both the Curie's enormous contributions to science. In 1944, a new radioactive element was discovered with atomic number 96, and it was called curium. One of the units used to detect radioactivity is called a curie, after both Curies. Three radioactive minerals, curite, sclodoskite, and cuprous sclodoskite, are named for the Curies. She also has an asteroid named after her, the 7000 Curie. The world of the 20th and 21st century was shaped by Curie's efforts in both the physical and sociological aspects. In addition to her Nobel Prizes, Marie has won multiple other awards and accolades. Poland proclaimed 2011 the year of Marie Curie during the International Year of Chemistry. The great scientist is referred to as Madame Curie throughout the many biographies that she is the subject of. February 11th, International Day of Women and Girls in Science. The United Nations has long placed a high priority on gender equality. The goal is to encourage female participation and full and equal access in science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, STEM fields. However, girls and women continue to be underrepresented in science. In 2018, approximately 1 in 3 researchers, 33%, were women. On the 22nd of December 2015, the United Nations General Assembly designated the 11th of February as the International Day of Women and Girls in Science in an effort to promote gender equality and women's and girls' empowerment. Men are typically thought to predominate in the scientific community. However, the women we talked about today broke down barriers and achieved important discoveries. We want even more women to continue Marie Curie's amazing scientific career. Thank you very much, Marie Curie. We will cover many more female scientists in upcoming videos. Stay tuned. If you like this video, make sure to subscribe for more. You can also share it on social media. Is there a subject you are super interested in and would like to watch on this channel? Write it in the comments below, please. Click the like button and don't forget to click on the bell icon to stay up to date with my latest videos. I'm sure you'll find many interesting videos on this channel. Thank you for watching.